I will point out that Mr. Pawan Dugal has really elaborated regarding cyber space, and that Yahoo case where French court has granted the interim injunction, but simultaneously US court has said that this is my website, how can you grant the stay, how can you grant the injunction, this is my software. Therefore these things are happening, and which law will prevail, whether the domestic law will prevail or the, it has to be guided by the treaties. What the treaty Mr. Pawan Dugal has pointed out, I think a fresh treaty has to be prepared, because that was a treaty before coming into force of Information Technology Act, that is in 1999. Now drastic amendments have been made, and now every representative has to sit and has to draft a fresh treaty governing the entire scope of the amended law, terrorism, and all those they have to deal with in a fresh treaty. In one of the conferences, I was there in South. When the conference was going on, the Secretary IT was sitting just near to me. He has said, Mr. Tandon, what has happened today, do you know?
I know.
There was a patient in the hospital, and the doctor, what the diagnosis has been given, medicines have been prescribed. Some medicines have been prescribed from USA. Who was his partner? Now they are dragged down, both are. Both have inimical terms. They have prescribed some treatment, some medicines on the website, and that has been diagnosed, that has been given by the doctor, and ultimately he died. That was the, then the doctor, when he has seen that neither he has prescribed those medicines, and how it has come on the computer, these are the wide space, this is the world space of cyber. We have to think about it. Who is guilty, who is not. That has, a treaty has to be prepared in this connection. These are the examples. For that purpose, we have forensic labs and all that, but the forensic labs are not sufficient. We have got only 4 forensic labs, one Delhi, one Hyderabad, one Bangalore, and one Calcutta. These are not, every state has to be a forensic lab. In Bombay Blast case, Parliament case, the matter was sent to the Hyderabad for forensic labs, for investigation. And therefore, every state has to be a good forensic lab for tracing out the crime, because under the new amendment, all these have been taken as evidence. These are things. Now compare and proceed.
I think the time is almost
over. I will take only 2-3 minutes. Honorable Justice Rajesh Tandon, Dr. Bhushan Roy, Ms. Pawan Dugal, and friends. Neither am I an expert in cyber law nor a techno-savvy person. But why I am here, I started my journey with this judiciary and other people quite long. I felt there are some challenges and issues before this administration of justice. Who is running the administration of justice? Our Indian judicial academies are well equipped. They are training the judges. But our experience shows this is not enough to train judges in the judicial academy. Because in judicial academy we are training only judges. Then we had we had dialogues many times. Dr. Bhushan Roy himself presented in a conference in southern most part of India They have the deliberation started. Subsequently, that is in February 2008, 2009. Then in 2009, June, again we had a wider range of dialogue in presence of police officers and prosecutors. We had an elaborate discussion later. Then we found there is a point in discussing this matter in presence of police and prosecutor and judges. Then we approached, we gave the report to the Supreme Court. Honorable Chief Justice of India constituted a national project committee on enforcement of cyber law. This is the second project committee Supreme Court is constituting. I think most of you are aware, the first one is the mediation project committee, the second one. Honorable Justice Arthanas is hearing that one. The objectives of the committee is identifying the issues and challenges in enforcing cyber crime. Secondly, promote dialogue between members who are responsible for administration of justice. Next, discuss the case studies on use and abuse of technological advancement in the context and consequences. Fourthly, evolve mutually acceptable strategies in serving positive justice and rule of law while enforcing cyber law. Lastly, develop a frame updated and equipped cater for effective enforcement of justice administration system. Now, we are working on this one. This committee, I think, Honorable Justice is also taking a lead role in that. But my submission is that whatever in your mind, because this is a mixed group of audience, jurists, lawyers, judges, law students, and public also here. Whatever in your mind, in any experience, you want to tackle that aspect through enforcement, kindly pass on to Honorable Justice Rajesh Tandon. In January, we are planning to have a long-term and short-term plan of action from 2010 to 2012. For that, you can also part of that. Can hope for an effective and most member cyber law.
Sushant, Janki Prasad and Kazi Mohammed.
Consider the per second pulse as a mandatory option along with other tariff plans at the International Telecommunication Union World Summit Geneva has put the telecom in a threat. Clarifying the meaning of mandatory option, Mr. Sharma explained that it will be mandatory for the operators to offer at least one such plan, but optional for the consumers whether or not they wish to subscribe to such a plan or not. TRAI would come up soon with a consultation paper on the matter and also invite suggestions on the per-second billing model. The day this announcement was made, it battered the stock prices of telecom companies on 6th October, with the sector leaders losing the most. On the Bombay Stock Exchange, Reliance Communications lost nearly 11% to close at 68. Its bigger competitor, Bharti Airtel, lost 10%. Idea Cellular, MTNL, Tata Tele each dropped between 8% and 4%. Analysts and market players expect more cuts in the days to come. A bit about TRAI. TRAI is the regulator in the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India Act 1997. The object of the Act is to provide for establishment of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India to regulate the telecommunication and services and for matters connected therewith or incidental thereto. Now, one of the functions of the Act is to facilitate competition and promote efficiency in the operation of telecommunication services so as to facilitate growth in such services. While another important function is to protect the interest of the consumer of telecommunication service. TRAI is empowered under the Act to notify in the official gazette the rates at which the telecommunication services within India and outside India shall be provided under this Act, including the rates at which messages shall be transmitted to any country outside India, and TRAI may further discharge of its functions issue such directions from time to time to the service providers as it may consider necessary. Coming to the impact of the announcement made by TRAI chairman, telcos are presenting this note as an unsustainable tariff proposal. A pro-consumer declaration shall be affecting millions of shareholders and several stocks. CEOs of various telcos are waiting for the try to start consultations on the issue. At present, the customers are charged per minute, even if they use the service for less than a minute. Switching over to a system of pay per second would affect their revenues adversely. Already the tariff war among telcos is taking a heavy toll on their stocks. Prior to this, TRAI did not ever make such a recommendation. Such a move would disturb the equilibrium achieved in telecom sector through free competition and market growth. Taking care of consumers' immediate and long-term interest will adversely affect new competitors or entrants as well as industry margins. The move is tilted adversely against telcos' interest and raised important issues of predatory pricing. Since some operators are already offering such billing models of pay per second, the other operators may follow suit voluntarily to compete with them. Intervention by TRAI in such a scenario is premature, unwarranted and uncalled for. Telcos should be left to take their own economic decisions. Already the offer by some of the service providers of pay per second plan is being viewed as anti-competitive, distorting entry for new competitors as a result, a threat to existing operators. Suggested billing model raises issues of trying to over-regulate the telecom market, which has so far worked fairly well. TRAI has been exercising a policy of forbearance on tariffs for many years. With more than 10 operators per circle already engaged in the tariff war, no evidence of market failure or consumer dissatisfaction, TRAI's move seems incomprehensible and unacceptable. India is a large market for telecommunications, having plenty of competition, and the announcement by TRAI's chairman is a move towards consumer getting the best possible service at the best possible price. In view of the large number of operators in Indian market, vast number of consumers, there is already healthy competition in the mobile telecom sector. It is reflected in the fact that mobile tariffs in India are among the lowest in the world. In such a scenario, telcos are finding it difficult to accept intervention of TRAI with competitive forces. Some of the telecom players in the country have already launched per second pulse, but such tariff plans are non-mandatory and are mostly aimed at expanding their penetration and expanding market share. To illustrate, BSNL introduced 1 paise per second pulse for local calls and 2 paise per second pulse for STD in Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. Tata Docomo is offering users per second pulse on its GSM network in Delhi. Airtel have also extended pay per second calling plan from Kolkata, Odisha, UP as well as Delhi. The mobile telephone sector has to be highly competitive and in fact there is already a cutthroat competition between existing players in the market. This is always beneficial to the consumer as operators are forced to innovate and bring new tariff plans suitable to different consumers. Since the marginal